yes, I'm pro IMC, and you have to be careful.
So if IMC,
well, routine, yeah, it's not really routine, but define it. Four more positive flows. Four more positive flows, more extracapsular expansion, probably the higher risk, the lot of LGI, cheaper negative. So I select the higher risk. I don't really change my technique for the IMC. I very, very rarely I do the on fast electron. I try to use tangents, wide tangents, and I drop a little bit in the lower parts. And I use breast hold all the time. And then at the end of the day, what UTBH will show. And you try to tweak things, and then you come up with the best plan. But IMC will bring with it cardiac toxicity, especially on all those patients that already received cardiac toxicity drugs. So we have to be careful with that.
Dr. Vicky, would you have a comment on this part from the European point of view, sir?
First, with respect to the cost, yes, it's true also in Italy that the MRT is high price with respect to it. It's not the rate probably is similar to the United States, but our level of reimbursement is low. So that means just to translate, the cost for breast irradiation in PD conformer is about 6,000 euros. And the cost for EMRT is 10,000 euros. May change, may vary between among the different regions in Italy because it's not so homogeneous. We have common terms. The reimbursement is based on regions. In Lombardy, it's 10,000. But this is not the reason because people move to 3D to. As I said, we have some price to pay. First is state of tools. We have an experience about 300 cases with TOMO. And obviously, we have to follow and to assess what is the impact of enlarged volume on the earth, enlarged volume on the lung. Volume to an aspected organ at risk, that's as mentioned before, the spine, for example. We have also to report this in case of, fortunately, this patient need to be treated for a metastasis in the future, maybe to consider that it's not zero, it goes to the spine, it is in this case. Currently, the advantage is that in spite of hypofractionation, we are pushing on hypofractionation, seems that at least from the cosmetic point of view, etc., we are more homogeneous in the dose, can avoid probably some problems related to the cosmetic organ. For the other organs, really is a subject of study, and we have to wait longer for a while. What is important that independent from randomization, etc., all these patients have to be checked in controlled studies, so institutional study of the patient checked and followed, and in order also for us, like happened for IORT, to understand better after some years. Another point, just to mention that maybe an advantage, I am an old traditional causes, but when also in case of regional evaluation, so just to be clear, we are using TomoDire for breast, when breast only, and Eritol, we have a chemoprostate, EMRT. In this case, we have only one volume, so we have not the need to junction between the fields. So in this case, maybe, I don't know, a little advantage.
My question about for case of presented with locally advanced breast cancer and receive adequate course of new adjuvant chemotherapy followed by breast conservative surgery was morphologically node negative after adequate lymph node dissection. Role of radiotherapy for locally regional lymph node?
Well, the answer, we need another presentation of 30 minutes. And he will kill me if I do that. But there is no standard of treatment for it. There is no standard of treatment. But I will tell you what we do. And I will tell you what the trial in the US is basically trying to ask this question. If we have a large chance and the patient will receive neoadjuvant chemotherapy, we check the with ultrasound, not just palpating, with ultrasound. And if there is anything there, we document that it is positive. So we go to an FNA or a core biopsy. So now we have a good clinical stage, T and the N. Now, if the patient has a positive lymph node ultrasound, and they go into neoadjuvant chemotherapy, and there is a complete pathologic response, what do we do? Basically, there is now a randomized trial by RTG and NSAB looking at this specific question and randomizing between breast versus breast and vaginal radiation. So suggest that we don't know the answer. But this trial just started maybe a year ago. Until the end of it, what do? I lean towards giving radiation because the control is giving radiation and the tested arm is not giving radiation. So I will give regional radiation if I have a documented positive lymph node before the adjuvant chemotherapy. And the same thing with mastectomy. The patient had a mastectomy and a lymph node which became negative after the adjuvant chemotherapy. They are randomizing between post-mastectomy radiation or not. So again, the question is not out, the answer is not out yet, so I lean towards